Hello and welcome in this video about the faces annotation feature in Peakto. Peakto lets you annotate people and run filters based on faces information, and I'm going to show you how this works. Faces appear in a dedicated screen where you can see all the faces in the source you're currently selected. I'm first going to show you how you can leverage existing work that you've done in other apps, such as here in Lightroom, where I had started to annotate this particular catalog. And then I'm going to show you what happens when you start from scratch. So let's look at this catalog that I had partially annotated inside Lightroom. When I ingested in Peakto, I get this section telling me that I have people annotated in other apps, in that case Lightroom, and they appear with a question mark next to their name. So I can go through each of them and simply hit return to validate John, like in this example, and then John becomes a named person. Or I can use a new menu here to validate all of these people that I had already taken time to annotate in Lightroom, and now they become official faces inside Peakto. The way faces work in Peakto is we are going to create clusters with people as soon as we get more than a certain number of images that show a particular face. So you won't find a cluster with only one person, but there is a minimum of 3 or 5 person in order to create a cluster. So here, for example, I'm looking at this cluster of 7 images, which is currently untagged. The way you can create a person with that cluster is simply by entering a name. So here I'm going to create a new person called Hannah, which now becomes part of my named people. Here is another cluster with 27 images, and these are images of someone I already have here. So my catalog was partially annotated. So this person, John, in this example, already exists. So it's very simple. You can click here, type John, or you can also just validate John because Peakto thinks that this person might be John. So this pop-up menu here that comes up is going to show you the persons that are more likely to be the one that you are going to annotate. So I'm just validating John. Here, I can click here and probably Lila as well. So all these images are coming from Unsplash account called Heftiba, which we are using because there are lots of people that are appearing in many images. If I want to tag all my images, and especially those images that have people that do not occur very often and are not part of any cluster, I can simply go to Detail View and start the annotation flow from any image. So here, this is John. It was not recognized because of the position of its head. So I'm just going to validate John, and then it's going to go to the next untagged face, which I can validate by entering a new person. Actually, this is Kate, new person. And then it goes to the next. Okay, baby. And you get the idea. It's going to move through all the images with untagged people. So to summarize, you can reuse existing tags. You can then leverage the ability from Peakto to create clusters of people that it has recognized to be the same. And then you can go into detail mode and annotate either image per image or in a flow. Next, how do you use and the faces that you've annotated? Well, you can use them using filters. So if I go and click on the faces filter, I can see all the persons that I have annotated here. And by simply clicking on any of those names, I'm going to create a filter that you can see here in the search bar for that specific person. So here I've ingested a full folder of DP review images, about more than 12,000 of them. And after the ingestion has finished and AI and faces have been has been running, I can go to my faces tab and I will see here all the unnamed clusters that have been recognized. So here, because I'm ingesting from a folder, I don't have any pre-existing work. Everything is new, so I have all these clusters. And basically the process is to go through all of them, starting probably with the bigger ones and annotating them. So here, for example, I recognize Jordan from DP Review, previously DP Review, and I can go through all these people and annotate them. Here is Chris Nichols. Right. Whenever I see a cluster that where I have some doubts, for example, this one, I can just open the window and all these images are probably coming from a specific test image and I'm going to ignore it. So this is a cluster I'm not interested in. And like this, I'm going to move through all my clusters, annotating lots of people at once. Once you finish that work and you've left with only small clusters or clusters of people you don't know, you can use the ignore all and it's going to ignore all these people at once. You can always undo what you've been doing. So we hope you like this feature and wish you some good annotation time. Bye-bye.